If your team manages an AWS S3 account, you'll know that it's very difficult to upload new assets. Amazon makes it difficult to log in with two-factor authentication, and quite honestly, you probably don't want everyone on your team to have access to your AWS S3 account. A few years ago, with a marketing team I work with, I found a Slack add-on called BucketBot. It was a really cool thing, and you just installed it on your Slack account, you threw a file in it, and it threw it up on Amazon S3 for you. Well, about 3 or 4 years ago, they depreciated that app, and we really used it a lot by then. So I took it upon myself to build a new version of that using make.com. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build that automation using Slack and make.com so your team can easily upload assets to your S3 buckets without having to log in. My name is Andy O'Neill, and I help entrepreneurs like you add time-saving automations to their business. Please check out the description for links to the cool no-code tools and software that I use, as well as a link to subscribe for my newsletter. And as always, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you are interested in more content like this. So the way this works is I'm over here in Slack, and I call this the BucketBot channel. You're just going to create a channel on your Slack. If you want it to be private, you can do that, so only certain people can get to it. But this channel is pretty well wide open for anybody to use on this particular team we're on. And what you do is you just go here and you can drag a file over to that. And I'm going to grab this right here. All right, so here's the thumbnail for this video. It was handy. So I just drag it over there and I hit enter. And what's going to happen is our scenario is going to run, and it's going to bring back a URL for us. And right here is that URL. It came back really fast because this isn't a huge file. So you can see here, if I click on this, I'll go directly over to an AS3 link that has this file. So it's super simple to upload it. You just throw a file in there and hit submit. Let's go see how this scenario works. All right, you can actually see the execution that I just ran. It took 5 operations and took 1 second. That's why it came through so fast. I will say, if you're going to put huge files in here, make sure your make.com account will handle it. There are some file limits on different plans. This particular plan the client is on is fairly sizable, and so running bigger files through is typically not a problem. So you can see right here in our scenario, this is our trigger, and this is the file that came through. This particular trigger is watching for a new event that is a new file. So you want to make sure you select that, because sometimes there's some conversation that happens in this channel, and we don't want that trying to run through and uploading things to Amazon. All right, the next step is we're going to get a file. And what this looks like is you're going to add the file ID here from that first scenario. So we got to get the file information, and now we're going to download the file. So here you're going to put the download file module, and you're going to put that URL private download right there. So that's the link you're going to map into this module. Next, you're going to upload to Amazon. So if you're using Amazon, you're probably comfortable with this, but basically you're going to need to create a connection. You're going to have to select the region. Make will let you select the wrong region, and the scenario just won't work. So make sure you look at the particular bucket you're connecting to and find out what region it is. And then select the bucket. And then if you have a folder even further down into your buckets, you can put that here. Right here, I'm going to map. I'm not going to just take what's given to me from Slack, because I want to do some editing on this file name. So what I'm going to do is there's an event timestamp that comes from Slack that I'm going to place in there. That timestamp is just numbers representing the down to the second of when this was uploaded. I add that there because if you upload the same file over and over again, it will get a unique URL based on this timestamp. Next thing I'm doing is I'm using the replace function, and I am looking for spaces here, and I am replacing them with a hyphen. I'm also putting the lowercase function in there just to lowercase everything. So we're going to have a nice clean URL, no spaces, no capitalization. And then I'm sending the data right here from that download. And if we look back over here at our URL, you can see here is that timestamp. And then everything is lowercase here with all the spaces removed and hyphens put in place of those spaces. So that's a nice, properly structured, clean URL that someone can now click and go use someplace else. All right, back in our scenario. Next, I just reply with a link. Here is your file. We could actually call that here is your link. This is our AS3 root URL, and then I'm just putting that same file name pattern in there like I did over here when we created the file. So once this is uploaded, it sends that message back with the link, and it's done. This is far more efficient for uploading to Amazon S3 than actually logging in and going through the process of finding the bucket and uploading. Unless you can do that in 1 second, then this is probably the way to go to save time uploading to Amazon. Thank you for watching, and if you ever need one-on-one assistance for building make.com scenarios, check out the link in the description and you can book a call with myself or a member of my team, and we will give you one-on-one help right over Zoom. See you next time.